I'm Ethan Winkler. I'm a vascular neurosurgeon at UCSF. I specialize in vascular malformations, including AVMs and aneurysms. In the normal cerebral circulation, the blood is under pressure in the artery in order to drive fluid flow. That's how the blood moves throughout the brain. And because of the number of branch points in the normal vasculature, that pressure is dissipated before it gets to the more fragile venous system. In arterial venous malformations, this normal patterning becomes abnormal between arteries and veins without an intervening capillary bed. You have high blood pressure in more fragile blood vessels, making them prone to bleeding. When an arterial venous malformation progresses to the point of bleeding, it results in a severe form of stroke called hemorrhagic stroke, meaning a bleeding stroke. The patient experiences sometimes the onset of a sudden intense headache, new numbness, weakness, or alterations in their mental status. For AVMs that have ruptured, where a patient presents usually to the hospital, they're at higher risk for bleeding again. So we recommend surgery or radiosurgery for those AVMs. When we perform surgery to remove an AVM, we remove a portion of the skull temporarily to gain access to the AVM. We then work around the AVM to decrease its blood supply and remove it in one piece. Many patients stay on the average of 3 to 5 days in the hospital to recover. Even after they leave the hospital, many patients may experience temporary fatigue or headaches. In many situations, those headaches and fatigue resolve over several weeks, and most patients are able to go back to work in about 6 weeks' time. With radiosurgery, we perform it as an outpatient procedure with a machine called Gamma Knife. And the Gamma Knife delivers a high dose of focused radiation to the AVM to shrink it. Many patients are able to go home the same day. The most common side effect is temporary headaches, but many patients can return to work within a week. With the different treatment modalities, we observe different rates of cure. With surgery, the cure rates are in excess of 90% and they are immediate. Whereas with Gamma Knife radiosurgery, the cure rates range about 60 to 80%. And they're delayed, taking on the order of 3 to 5 years. One of the other options is endovascular embolization. This, however, is rarely curative, so many instances we only use this treatment option in conjunction with either open surgery or radiosurgery, in which we use hollow tubes called catheters that are put inside of an artery either in your wrist or the top of your leg. We're then able to navigate these tubes up to the arterial venous malformation to deliver specialized glues in order to reduce the blood supply. AVMs can be diagnosed before they have bled, or what we refer to as being unruptured. This commonly is an incidental finding, and we think about four treatment options. Observation, endovascular embolization, open surgery, and radiosurgery. When we find an AVM, the factors we consider in deciding how to best treat it are related to the patient's age, overall health, the AVM size, and whether or not it may be easily surgically accessible. Our preference is to perform surgery whenever possible and safe because of the highest cure rates. For AVMs, which may be deeper inside of the brain or harder to get to with surgery, in many instances, we recommend Gamma Knife radiosurgery. For AVMs that are not causing neurologic symptoms in patients with older age, sometimes we elect to do observation, where we repeat imaging yearly to look for the development of features that may predict that the AVM is on the verge of bleeding. UCSF is one of the highest volume AVM treatment centers in the United States. We have a large multidisciplinary team with expertise in neurosurgery, neurology, radiology, and many other specialties. And our nursing staff, residents, and nurse practitioners are very accustomed to treating patients with the most complex cases from across the nation.